do you really define compartment syndrome? Can you tell me just one word? What is compartment syndrome and how do you really define it?
Sir, increase in the pressure of inside the compartment more than the normal.
What pressure? Is it a clinical diagnosis or you rely on the pressure being measured?
So mainly it's a clinical diagnosis, sir.
Yes, good. It's mostly a clinical diagnosis than the measurement of pressure. Though, as you rightly said, it's an increase of pressure in a compartment. How many compartments are there in the leg? Dilip, I'm going to the basics. How many compartments are there in the leg? Because it is important to know how many compartments are there to know when do you release it and what do you release and how you release it. How many compartments are there in the leg? The leg is very important. That's the most common site for compartment syndrome, don't you?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, which is the most common site? It's the leg. Number two is?
Forearm, sir.
Forearm, good. And rarely it can happen in the hand and the foot or even in the thigh. So how many compartments are there in the leg? You must know because how do you really go about it?
So four, sir?
Yeah, good. There are four compartments. So as your definition of whenever the pressure in a compartment, either in the leg or in the thigh or forearm or foot, increases beyond normal, it is called compartment syndrome. However, it varies from patient to patient, we should understand, and from compartment to compartment with the mean average. So many times you may have to compare it with the other side. So I asked this question, how many compartments are there in the leg? As you see here rightly, there are four compartments which are important. The posterior deep and the posterior superficial and the lateral compartment and the anterior compartment. Why I ask this question is, you know, these compartments all will have to be released when there is a compartment, especially the deeper compartments. I go on to Jane. How many compartments are there in the forearm? Dilip said the second common. Yes, actually compartment syndrome initially was described in the forearm because of tight bandages put or in a supracondylar fracture resultant of a supracondylar fracture. Later it was modified. How many compartments are in the forearm, Jayan?
Sir, there are three compartments in the forearm: the volar, the dorsal, and the mobile ward.
Volar, dorsal, and
sir, the brachioradialis compartment.
It was Griffiths who described initially this aspect way back almost when we were students, nearly say 55 years ago. So there are two compartments, volar, isn't it? That's important from a clinical point of view, why a particular deformity occurs. So it is the superficial and the deeper group of muscles. The deeper group of muscles are, it is there, you can the deeper group of muscles in the forearm, which results in a particular deformity. The superficial muscles, you know, the flexor digitorum, sublimis, flexor carpi radialis, and flexor carpi ulnaris, and the pollicis longus. The deeper are flexor digitorum profundus, and the flexor pollicis longus. That's why is the deeper compartment, which when it goes into contracture, it will result in a deformity, which is called main entrapy. Really pulls down the thumb, terminal phalanx, and the other fingers as well. How many compartments are in the foot, dear? Mainly, there are four compartments, which is delineated further into nine. How many compartments are in the hand?
Five compartments.
No, there are 11 compartments, including the hypothenar, the thenar, and the dorsal and the ventral introsion. With this fundamental anatomy, when you understand these compartments, you can understand what will happen when there is a squeezing of this muscle and the blood which is collected or the fluid which is collected, it does not go out and it really pressurizes the particular muscle or group of muscles, resulting in this particular syndrome. What we should understand is a true emergency. And how soon you act and how you release is extremely important. Why I selected this subject is, here is a patient which I show you so you understand the emergency part of it. This patient, after a nailing, which we have done 12 hours after open fracture of the tibia, came to us after 5 days with this particular picture. See this, there is already blackening of the toes. The nailing, unfortunately, hasn't been done very well. That was not the point. The fibula has been fixed like that. So immediately we took him to the theater with an idea of whether we could save the limb. But it was already 5 days. And we just opened. You would appreciate there was almost brownish black tissue of the posterior compartment and the posterior two compartment. So this patient required an amputation. There was no reason that this limb should have been amputated. If it was diagnosed early and proper treatment was given and resulted in that tragedy. That's why the emphasis is compartment syndrome in your clinical practice. Leave alone the examination which you ensue, where you can get a compartment syndrome, a sequelae of a compartment syndrome. It is very important that when you are in the casualty, you will have to recognize as early as possible a compartment syndrome. Here is a limb. Unfortunately, that the other leg is not very well shown. But you would see that is the limb. How do you diagnose that this patient has a compartment? Dilip said it is a clinical diagnosis. Well, it is right that it is mostly a clinical diagnosis. But for recording, it is always better to record the pressure. But in this particular limb which you see here, do you say this patient has a compartment syndrome or not? Can Raghavan answer that question? Raghavan, Tuck, he's not there. Saurabh.
Yes, sir.
Who is it? Saurabh.
Yes. Sir, we can ask the patient we can ask him for the toe movements, and if it is able to do the toe movements, then probably we can exclude it.
Yeah, that's it. No, the most toe movement can be, there can be some movement. The most important is in any limb which comes like this, see there is a huge swelling in the lateral compartment, medial compartment. And there are blips which delineates there is some compartment pressure. So your hand should go to feel the dorsalis pedis, whether there is any pulsation, number one. Number two, the toe movements. Yes, the toe movements, but what is the characteristic feature of a toe movement? If it is compartment syndrome, that's what I'm asking.
Those toe movements will be painful.
It will be painful. Any movement will be painful. And pallor, anesthesia, all the paresthesia and all are secondary. Most important is loss of pulse and painful movement of the fingers or the toes. Well, I am just putting you this fracture. The same patient had this fracture. How it can be dealt with? What type of fracture is that? Whether the limb patient has come to you like this, or you take an X-ray like this, how do you proceed? So it's the SARS-CoV-5, would have been with the shattered fracture almost extending into that you can call it even 6, but you appreciate that the posterior fragment has gone posteriorly and there is a likelihood that there is a vascular injury. So how do you proceed?
First, I will try to immobilize the fracture. Might be on Thomas.
You will put a immobilize with the plaster?
No.
You will have to be very specific what will you do.
I will apply the Thomas splint.
Thomas splint is Hugh Owen. Thomas will turn in his grave if you tell that I will put a Thomas splint to this limb. You will have to put an external fixation.